What are your favourite shapes?
Oh, well, I love fractals. So any shape that's, you know, mathematically derived. So do we still have a fractal here? So fractals are just absolutely beautiful. So I'm an applied mathematician, which means that I love taking the mathematical toolkit that I've developed over many years and applying that to problems of real significance to society. Maths is everywhere, and a mathematician is able to see the beauty in all of that, but also the potential in all of that. You know, once you look at something with a mathematical lens, you have the ability to describe how it is, you have the ability to describe how it could be, and how you can shift and how you can improve. One of the most enjoyable things for me has been getting out there and talking to students and teachers and parents and trying to help them understand the importance of young people choosing to continue with their mathematics. One of the great things about mathematics is that it's an abstract language, and with that language you can model all sorts of things. The detail doesn't matter so much when you're collaborating with a biologist or a physiologist or an ecologist or any of those ologists. You have to understand their language first and understand what their problem is before you can even get to the point of applying any mathematics. And so, you know, I've spent quite a number of years understanding, you know, enough biology that I can have a conversation with a stem cell biologist or a physiologist. Understanding the essence of the problem, that's always an enjoyable part, getting to the point where you can describe something as a maths problem. Then you can just throw at it your whole arsenal of mathematical techniques and try to come up with the best solution. And then there's the taking that mathematical solution and translating that back into the real world context, something that's actionable. Pythagoras was famous for his triangle theorem, but Pythagoras did a lot of good work on understanding the relationship between mathematics and music. I do know many mathematicians who are musicians as well. Certainly that's what I like to do in my time off when I'm not being a mother and dealing with, you know, the whole work-life balance issues. My relaxation time is every Tuesday night. I go to my orchestra rehearsal and, you know, I thrash out some Beethoven or something like that. The very process of spending a few hours just playing music somehow changes my brain, I think. I don't know. Maybe I'm kidding myself, but I come home and I just feel completely powerful. I just feel like I can tackle those hard problems that I've put aside during the week. This year I had the privilege of playing with the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra in their community outreach program. They have a thing called Symphony in a Day. The brain plays tricks on you. So I'm sitting there in the cello section and the most amazing sounds around me, and my fingers are playing, and my brain actually thought I was making that sound. And then I realised it wasn't me, it's them. It's the people next to me that sound amazing. But my brain got tricked into thinking, because my fingers are moving and I'm hearing it, my brain got tricked into thinking that was me. And for a moment there, I got this glimpse of what it would be like to be an amazing player. It was fabulous.